Hello again, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross and Bob Cottle set to bring you 2 great hours of World Championship Wrestling action. A little bit later in the broadcast, our colleague Gordon Sully will present a very special championship report. But, Bob, we've got a lot more.
Oh, Jim, we certainly have. We're going to go back, fans, and look at some of the great action that took place at Starrcade. Plus, Michael Wall Street. We'll meet Tommy Rich right here.
It's going to be a great 2 hours, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, let's go to the ring and our first event tonight on World Championship Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way in the ring area from the outside, it's Beautiful Bobby! And his opponent already in the ring from Naples, Italy, at 262 pounds, the Italian Stallion.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the world spaghetti-eating champion, the Italian Stallion, getting quite an rousing ovation as he'll take on that man, Beautiful Bobby. And while we have the opportunity, a big rematch from Starrcade, it'll be Beautiful Bobby taking on the Z-Man tomorrow on the main event at 6:05, Bob.
That's going to be some match, Jim. As you say, tomorrow night right here on TBS, 6:05, the main event. The Stallion is a big one. He's got a lot of raw talent and a lot of raw ability, but he's in against a real master, Jim, a fellow with a lot of experience who really throughout most of his outstanding career has been a tag team wrestler.
Beautiful Bobby forcing the Italian Stallion to the ropes. We had a clean break there. Saw that handshake at the beginning of the match. See how that sportsmanship transpires as this one progresses. Italian Stallion, as Bob Cottle said, has the advantage in size here. Grew up in Michigan, originally from Naples, Italy.
He's got a lot of weight compacted in that body of his, Jim. He's thick, he's broad, he's big, he's heavy, and with that weight, he might be able to move Bobby around the ring some.
Arm drag takeover by the Italian Stallion. Youngster came into pros. Beautiful Bobby started out as a teenager, but that young man, the Italian Stallion, spent many hours in the wrestling room and amateur wrestling, was an AAU national champion at one time. So his background is certainly solid. Another collar and elbow tie up. This time, Beautiful Bobby has the advantage, and there's a right hand. Caught him on the ropes and nailed him with a right.
Boy, you got to always keep your eyes on Beautiful Bobby. You got to watch every single move.
Italian Stallion tried to block Eaton. He did so, but Beautiful Bobby fires back up, and now the Italian Stallion takes him to the turnbuckle, face first, nails him again. And the Italian Stallion going up to the top rope. That's Beautiful Bobby's domain. And he nails Beautiful Bobby with a double axe handle. On top now, there's a lateral press, and Eaton kicks out.
He's wrestling a good match, Jim. So far, he's taking the action too beautiful. Hey, we got, what is this, Santa Claus at ringside?
Santa Norman here.
Yes.
Look, 3 days before Christmas, good old Norm is out. He's got his old hospital pajamas on, the red ones.
He's got a toy bag there, Jim, throwing toys and all up to the kids in the audience.
Beautiful Bobby not too...
Hey, he gave Bobby one.
I don't think... Beautiful Bobby rolled up. He may be pinned. He got two.
Hey, what's the big idea?
Beautiful Bobby said, what's the big idea?
Oh, now, wait a minute. If you don't hit Santa Claus, my heaven.
Oh! Norman, or Santa, whatever you want to call him, just nailed Beautiful Bobby. And there's the season to be jolly, and he's a jolly old soul, no doubt about that.
Yeah, there's one thing about it. Beautiful Bobby's not jolly right now after being floored by that right hand.
Norman stole a lot of those Norman teddy bears and some other World Championship Wrestling souvenirs to the kids here in attendance at Center Stage here in Atlanta.
Jim, that's the type of individual he is, too. He's such a big old teddy bear himself, this big Norman, and he loves kids. He loves young people, and that's just indicative of the type of person he is to be wanting to give them something at Christmas time.
Eaton with a side headlock, but the Stallion strong shoves him off. But a good football tackle by Beautiful Bobby comes to the near side. Gets some momentum. Leapfrog there by the Stallion. He blocks the right hand. Shot into the corner there. He reverses Beautiful Bobby in and catches him after the Irish whip with a clothesline. Stallion, Stallion brings Eaton. Oh, using leg strength to bring him out of the corner. Drop kick by the Stallion.
He is surprising Beautiful Bobby with his agility for a man that size.
Eatonville takes over now. So much for the offense by the Italian Stallion, as beautiful Bobby countered a couple of high-impact moves to turn the table on it.
You can never let your guard down when you got a man in there like beautiful Bobby. He's a seasoned veteran. He's been in the wars many, many times in that ring.
Wrecking at the eye of the Italian Stallion. We're telling you fans in Atlanta about the big holiday spectacular on Christmas night in the Omni with an 8 o'clock start time.
3 days away, and Jim, that's going to be a great one. As you say, we're going to tell the fans about some of those matches and where they'll be able to get tickets in just a few minutes.
Look, you got a good shot?
Good camera shot. That's what he requested. That's what he got. And we saw the right hand right to the face of the Italian Stallion. I haven't got on my Christmas shopping done, Bob. I'm going to Oklahoma for Christmas, but I'm going to be back in Atlanta on Christmas night because I don't want to miss that spectacular in the Omni at 8 o'clock.
Jim, as you said, and let me tell the fans just briefly, we got 9 tremendous bouts. You know, that's the big wrestling event of the year, of any year, Jim, is the Christmas night event there in the Omni. 9 big bouts, including a world title match, also a cage match. It's going to be the Horseman against Doom in that cage match.
Italian Stallion trying to fight his way back up. Beautiful Bobby has reasserted himself in this contest. As Bob Caudle mentioned, Beautiful Bobby has amassed a phenomenal reputation as a tag team wrestler. But in recent weeks, we've seen him very, very successful in one-on-one contests and without a manager. Beautiful Bobby gaining more and more confidence as every week progresses here in one-on-one wrestling.
That's right. He certainly is, Jim. Let me digress just a moment again to Christmas night when fans from all over the Southeast are going to be coming to Atlanta to the Omni Gym. Advanced tickets are on sale now at Ticketmaster outlets, including Turtles Records, Coconut, Selected Records, and tickets are available at the Omni box office on Christmas Day up until the match time on Christmas.
Bobby Eaton been raking at the eyes of the Italian Stallion. Blatant infraction of the rules. Randy Anderson, I don't think, is being very well adhered to by beautiful Bobby, but the Italian Stallion fights back using his bulk again. Catches Eaton and he power slams it. The power of the Italian Stallion now coming to the front. As Bob Caudle said, he's one of the strongest competitors in WCW as he elevates beautiful Bobby there up in the lights.
Well, Z-Man is hoping there's going to be enough of Bobby Eaton left for him for tomorrow night here on the main event.
Boy, they had a great match at Starrcade. That match has already been signed, returned for tomorrow night's main event. Beautiful Bobby holds on to the top rope. And he catches a Stallion with that running neck breaker. That should be all. The running neck breaker, a dynamic move, and a victory for beautiful Bobby.
The winner of the match, beautiful Bobby.
Fans, we're going to hear some comments from Michael Wall Street and Alexander York momentarily.
Well, and I tell you, as I mentioned, you can never let your guard down against Bobby Eaton. That running neck breaker right there. Put the Stallion away for the count of 3.
Later in the program, it's going to be Michael Wall Street and Tommy Wildfire Rich. Let's go to Wall Street and Ms. York and some computer information.
Tommy Rich, the most valuable commodity there is information. And in our computer banks, we have all the information we need to beat you. Don't we, Ms. York?
Absolutely, Mr. Wall Street. You know, Tommy Rich, you're a former world champion. You're a great competitor. However, the many years you've been in the sport have enabled us to gather all the information, your weaknesses, your strengths. Tonight, we'll beat you in less than 6 minutes.
You made a bad investment, Rich. I'm going to show you why.
Ladies and gentlemen, in this event, scheduled for one fall, making his way into the ring area from the University of Michigan at 260 pounds, Rick Steiner!
And Rick Steiner with a good old Santa Claus Norman tossing up some
poise. And his opponent,
some poise.
From St. Petersburg, Georgia, and doing it again, it's Barry Horowitz.
Barry Horowitz with his traditional pat of his own back to take on one half of the United States Tag Team Champions, Rick Steiner. He and his brother triumphantly represent the USA at the Pat O'Connor International Tag Team Tournament with a resounding victory in the final.
Well, they did that, Jim, and we had mentioned, and you and I had talked about it prior to the program. They really did the USA proud. There's no doubt because they're such fine young men, and to come away with, what is this? We got Santa playing with one of the toys that was in that toy bag.
I think that's a little stinger toy. From WCW Souvenirs. Well, Bill Barry Horowitz just destroyed the toy, and he's headbutted by Santa Claus Norman, and Rick Steiner now takes over on Barry Horowitz. I don't think Horowitz started the season off with a lot of cheer here.
Yeah, he made the wrong move when he went after that toy. He had Santa Claus Norman still in there, Rick Steiner also, and now Horowitz is paying for it. Horowitz is a type guy, Jim. I think he says, hey, if you don't pat your own self on the back, if you don't give your own self accolades, who's going to do it for you? He lives there.
Rick Steiner tossing Barry Horowitz outside, and Norman, I think a little upset that Horowitz stomped on that toy. And Norman continues to pass out the toys to the kids. And Horowitz with a headbutt on Rick Steiner. That didn't faze it. Barry says,
is that a hard hit or is that a hard hit?
This is no doubt Rick Steiner, a big kid at heart, his favorite time of the year. And there's a Steiner line by Rick Steiner, really nailing Barry Horowitz.
Not only is he hard upstairs, but he's hard, rock hard all over with that tremendous muscular body of his.
He's got Horowitz in Never Never Land.
Here's a suplex.
Belly to belly suplex with a second turnbuckle. Happy Hanukkah for Barry Horowitz. And with Santa Claus' help, he wins it.
The winner of the match, Rick Steiner.
Paul E. Daniels is going to be talking to Rick Steiner in just a few moments.
All right, and Jim, again, let's go back. And fans, look at this tremendous power of the Steiner line as Horowitz comes out of the corner. Boom, right on the button. And down goes Horowitz from that. And a belly-to-belly suplex off of the second rope. Horowitz, he may not be awake by Christmas after that.
Paul E. Dangerously is standing by with the dog-faced gremlin.
Okay, we already know that your brother went home for Christmas. I want to wish you a very Merry Christmas. Did you do a lot of shopping? Get all your shopping done for Christmas? Yeah? You buy a lot of toys for all your little friends in Michigan?
Yeah?
That's it. What'd you buy? Did you buy like a little train set for somebody? A little cousin?
None of your business.
Oh, now, come on. It's Christmas. I'm trying to be nice to you. Merry Christmas.
Yeah, it's none of your business.
Hey, whoa. Now, wait a minute. Wait. Easy.
Wait, no problem. Hey, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. It's a time of goodwill towards man. Okay? Sorry to interrupt your interview. Want to congratulate you on how you ran through the Nasty Boys. I mean, you guys beat them up, man. That was great.
Hey, you were great.
Great.
Yeah, you were great.
Just,
yeah.
Rick, just one simple thing we want to ask you.
Well, it would have to be simple, Mike.
Nah, come on now. Stop.
Jimmy?
Stop it.
Okay.
Stop, Jimmy.
All right, I'm sorry.
It's nice.
It's funny.
You guys.
Just joking.
You guys are the United States Tag Team Champions, right?
Yeah. Good answer.
Thank you. All right. All right. We consider ourselves a very, very good team. All we want to ask is, since I'm sorry that your brother ain't here, and the last thing we want to do is take advantage of you, but hey, since it's Christmas, what if you and me wrestle a captain's match? Okay, and if I win or you lose, we get a shot at the belts. What do I get? Thought you would ask that. Tell you what.
What?
If you win, you will never, ever have to worry, listen, or see the Freebirds again.
Do it.
Let it in. Hey, let's just do it right here.
No, let's just do it right here.
Come on.
You can be the referee.
No, I can't be it. I got a tie. You just wrestled.
You just wrestled.
We would want to take it. Let's take a little time. It's early. It's only a little bit after 6. I'll go get my gear on, you rest up, cool down, and we'll come back in a little while. What do you say?
Say yes.
Pretty yeah. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Merry Christmas.
We'll be back in a minute. You drive a hard bargain. We'll be back in a minute. You're a smart man. You're good. You're smart. Merry Christmas.
Yeah. This is a special Starcade report. We're here at the Kiel Auditorium in St. Louis, Missouri, where just moments ago Starcade 90 ended, and what a night of competition it was indeed. One of the outstanding series of matches was the first annual Pat O'Connor International Tag Team Championship Memorial Tournament. And I might point out, it was the Steiners, the U.S. team, against the Japanese in the final and main event for the title. Here's what happened.
I love it. They're raising the roof here at the old Kiel. There's a sleeper by Saito. Rick Steiner. Sunset flip on Saito.
No!
And he's going to get him.
Certainly one of the greatest matches I've seen in my years in professional wrestling. My special compliments to Masao Hattori, who did an outstanding job as an impartial official. Now, let's turn our attention to the U.S. Heavyweight Championship and the fact that Lex Luger went in under Hansen's terms and beat the man at his own game. For a moment, it looked like it was not going to prevail for Lex Luger, but then justice finally did prevail, and here's what happened as Lex Luger returned to the title.
Feet from regaining the United States Heavyweight Championship. Hansen pulling with all he has.
He's inches away, but it's a long few inches.
The ref, he cut the post. He did it, but the referee, I don't think, saw it.
Did you say he's won the match?
Luger with a lariat that touches the four corners. Ref.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and still United States Heavyweight Champion, Stan the Lariat.
Wait a minute, wait a minute.
No way.
Referee Randy Anderson saw it all. Luger with a clothesline.
Well, certainly kudos to Lex Luger. He overcame tremendous obstacles to regain the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. It looked for a moment like he wasn't going to get it back, but he has. Now we have to move on to the World Heavyweight Championship and this lengthy campaign by Scorpion to unnerve and destroy emotionally world champion Sting. Well, the match was in a steel cage. All of the odds seemed against Sting. But watch at this absolutely amazing turn of events.
DDT on the chair!
The DDT's a champion! We got 2 minutes left! 2 minutes left in the match in this whole pay-per-view!
Wham!
Anderson with a chair!
They're trying to finish him off for good! They are trying to finish Sting off for good!
Well, if it's a horseman in there, then it leads for me to believe that it would be...
There'll
be another horseman under that mask. Obviously.
No, no way. Well, who is it?
There's a Z-Man and Ricky Morton trying to climb the cage.
They got the cage door locked. Nobody's here to save Sting. Not even the little Stingers can save him now.
The Scorpion is on top of Sting, nailing him. The champion has been battered, but he beat the Black Scorpion. Here come the Steiners. They got some bolt cutters or something.
They better have some CPR skills. I think it's over for Sting.
Ric Flair.
Ric
Flair. Black Scorpion is Ric Flair.
It's Nature Boy Ric Flair.
A personal comment, if you will. I've known and respected Ric Flair as a world champion for a number of years. There have none been greater. However, what he has perpetrated, along with the horseman, on Sting, who is a good, a decent, and an honorable man, is most reprehensible. Very frankly, my opinion of Ric Flair has gone down a lot. You be the judge as to how you feel. And that's our Starcade report for this week.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event is scheduled for one fall. It is making his way into the ring area from Cincinnati, Ohio. 226 pounds, it's Flying Brian! And his opponent already in the ring from Tucson, Arizona, 250 pounds, this is Jim Corbett.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Flying Brian to take on Jim Corbett. Hope you enjoyed our Starcade report. We certainly want to thank the great fans that turned out from around the world, literally, that were in St. Louis with us this past Sunday night. Appreciate their great support of World Championship Wrestling. And still to come here, fans, if you just joined us, it's going to be Michael Hayes and Rick Steiner in the captain's match a little bit later in the broadcast. And if Michael Hayes wins, the Freebirds will get a U.S. tag title matchup. If they lose, if Hayes loses against Rick Steiner in this program, Steiner will never have to hear from the Freebirds again. Bob, I'm a little uncomfortable about this deal.
I'm uncomfortable about that also. And Paulie dangerously said to Rick Steiner, hey, you made a good deal. Steiner had sort of a blank expression. I think after it was all over, I'm not so sure that he thought he had made a good deal. I'm uneasy about it. You are. I think Rick Steiner may be uneasy.
That matchup coming up a little bit later in the broadcast, in addition to Michael Wall Street, who says he will beat Tommy Rich, or the computer says, in 6 minutes or less. That also still to come, plus our championship report with Gordon Solie. More on the World's Heavyweight Championship situation a little bit later in our broadcast. Nice move by Flying Brian, who has great quickness. It's this young man, along with the Z-Man, two of the hottest young single performers in the sport today.
They certainly are that. And Flying Brian, 226 pounds of dynamite. What a package that young man is, Jim, with the athletic ability that he's got. Just a great, tremendous athlete. He's got all of the agility and balance in the world. Just fantastic youngster. Well, I'm anxious to see, though. You're talking about Michael Wall Street in 6 minutes. That computer has not been wrong. I'm going to keep an eye on that, Jim. I'm anxious to see if he can do it. Tommy Rich in under 6 minutes.
Brian Bryan with both feet just nailed Jim Corbett and drove him all the way to the security railing. Still to come in this first hour, Big Sid Vicious is here. We'll see Tim Horner and Alan Irony go take on the Big Cat, the Motor City Madman. Ricky Morton will be here in one-on-one competition. We'll take a closer look at the World Tag Team title situation. What can be said about the street fight match that we saw last Sunday night in St. Louis? It had to be, in my career, one of the most physically intense battles that I've ever witnessed in any wrestling arena.
I don't think there's any doubt about that. And not only when you say what else can occur with that, they're going to be in a cage, Jim, and that's going to be part of the big Christmas spectacular at the Omni on Christmas night.
Flying Brian reversing Jim Corbett, takes him over the nice hip lock. Flying Brian extends those legs. Nice move. Great drop kicks, and Corbett rolls out of bounds to stop this onslaught of Flying Brian. The man, when he gets the momentum rolling and he can wrestle his tempo, that young man right there is one of the great ones. When he can wrestle his match and when he can dictate the pace, he's as good as anybody in the sport.
That's right, Jim, when he gets it going, as you say, and he certainly had it started right there. But have you ever seen anybody get any higher into the air with any more impact into the drop kick than Flying Brian? To get up that high and still have the tremendous force and power behind the drop kick that he's got.
Corbett now raking the eyes of Flying Bryant. Those forearms right to the chest. And Pillman, he raises it up a notch.
Boy, he's in excellent condition also. Keeps himself that way.
Great judo chops. And then the Flying Mare drops the elbow on Jim Corbett. Pillman now clearly in control of this contest here on TBS. Great weekend for you next weekend, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be our best of 1990 broadcast. Saturday morning in the Power Hour, Saturday night here on World Championship Wrestling. And next Sunday night, by the way, will be our match of the year in the best of 1990. And a special attraction next Saturday night. It has been signed. It will be the Z-Man Wrestling, Arn Anderson, for the television championship right here live from the center stage next Saturday night.
Well, and Jim, that's a young man that's really on a roll, too. You talk about Z-Man and Flying Brian. You mentioned them in the same breath earlier. What tremendous athletes they were. How far they had come as individual competitors in the ring. And that's going to be a whale of a match when the Z-Man meets Arn Anderson for that title. Well, we had some fantastic matches during the year, too, Jim. It's going to be great to go back and look at some of those tremendous matches next week.
Flying Brian now. Up on top, Air Pillman from the top rope. Flying Brian continues to win on TBS.
The winner of the match, Flying Brian!
My colleague Missy Hyde will join us in just a moment about tomorrow's main event, but we've got to take another look at Flying Brian.
Well, showing you that he's ready for any and all competition, Flying Brian. Look at that savant kick as he comes right around behind, right on the button with Jim Corbett. Flying Brian off of the top rope. And it's all over for Corbett after that.
We'll come back in just a moment with Big Sid Vicious. But now let's hear this from Missy Hyatt about tomorrow's outstanding main event.
Hi, I'm Missy Hyatt, inviting you to join Jim Ross and me tomorrow night for the main event at 6:05. We'll have two great Starrcade rematches, Terry Taylor versus Michael Wall Street, and Beautiful Bobby takes on the Z-Man.
Wrestling fans making his way in the ring area from anywhere he darn well pleases at 305 pounds, it's Sid Vicious! And his opponent already in the ring from Seymour, Indiana, 205 pounds, this is Scott Sandlin.
Scott Sandlin to take on the biggest horseman of them all, Big Sid Vicious. Vicious, 6'9", well over 300 pounds. Big and bad. I guarantee you, he's not in the Christmas spirit.
No, and I tell you, we ought to give Scott Sandlin a medal for getting in against this guy. Jim, wait a minute. Here's Santa Claus, Norman again out of ring. But is there anybody any bigger, any stronger, any meaner than this big man in the ring, Sid Vicious?
Hey, Norman, he's ready for Christmas, isn't he? 3 days away. Still passing out those presents. Vicious buries that foot right into the midsection of Scott Sandlin. And fans, Scott Sandlin is no small man.
Yeah, but look at this.
Vicious is a legitimate monster. He certainly has a
good
tremendous advantage for the horseman. And I don't think he likes Santa Claus, Norman, being out here.
Get out of here right now!
Jim, he's telling him to get out of here right now.
All the kids out there, Merry Christmas.
All Norman's out here just to wish everybody Merry Christmas and pass out these presents to all these youngsters that are in attendance here at the center stage.
Scott Sandlin earlier, Jim, off of that airplane spin to the shoulders of the big man. He went flying right through the air, just spinning halfway across the ring. Good heavens.
Vicious teammates, the horsemen involved in that tremendous cage match Christmas night in the Omni. You can almost count on Vicious being on that, right around that situation. I got a feeling the horseman got something up. And Norman, you're not going to be able to convince Vicious to get in the Christmas spirit.
He's a
giant Scrooge.
Yeah, he's not even thinking about Christmas at all. He probably is the type of guy that doesn't even give Christmas presents, Jim. Probably doesn't even want any.
Here goes.
There goes
a power bomb. Vicious just planted Scott Sandlin. And nails him. That's all. What an awesome specimen.
Winner of the match, Sid Vicious.
All right, Vicious with it. Let's keep it right here. I don't like the looks of this. Norman is not. Wait a minute.
From behind.
Oh, his head just cracked the ring post. Vicious from behind, and Norman's head just cracked the ring post. And Vicious taking that sack of toys and now kicking Norman right in the head all the way down the aisleway. But the severity of this situation, Norman's head just cracked the ring post with a resounding thud. Norman is hurt. We've got to get some attention for him. Fans, we'll check on Norman. We'll have a report on this momentarily. We'll be right back. He's hurt.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next event is scheduled for one fall. Making their way to the ring area, the team of the Big Cat from Kansas City, Missouri, at 365 pounds. And his partners in Detroit, Michigan, at 325 pounds, the Motor City Madman. Their opponents from Morristown, Tennessee, at 224 pounds, White Lightning, Tim Horner. And from the state of Kansas, at 238 pounds, Alan Iron Eagle.
Alan Iron Eagle and Tim Horner to take on the Big Cat and the Motor City Madman. And as a matter of fact, we do have some pre-recorded comments from this big team that'll be in the Omni Christmas night. And here's what they had to say.
Luger, Christmas night at the Omni. You better find yourself a partner, because the Big Cat and the Motor City Madman are coming after you.
That's right, Daddy. The Big Cat, the Motor City Madman. Luger, you better find a partner. You're going down, Daddy.
And you can hear the crowd chanting Luger, Luger. And I'm sure many of these fans will be with us here in Atlanta on Christmas night in the Omni when Lex Luger and El Gigante take on the Big Cat and the Motor City Madman. And in case you fans have been in exile, El Gigante is 7 feet 7 inches tall, 450 pounds, and he will join forces with Lex Luger on that big holiday spectacular right here in Atlanta's Omni on Christmas night.
Jim, nine great matches, and as you call it a spectacular, it certainly is that. Think of the four big men, as big as these four are going to be in the ring, all in one tag team match. That's going to be something. Talking about that on Christmas night, let me remind all the fans that Wednesday night, that's the day after Christmas, 7:30 p.m., we're going to be in Nashville, Tennessee at the Municipal Auditorium and in Columbia, South Carolina, Township Auditorium.
Tim Horner tried a high cross body, and the Motor City Madman caught him, goes for a big elbow, and Horner, the youngster from Morristown, Tennessee, quickly moves out of the way, working on the wrist lock. Tim Horner's an outstanding athlete.
Well, he and Iron Eagle aren't going to be able to match strength with these two, Jim. Big Cat, Motor City Madman, they're just too big and too strong and too powerful. And this is what Horner's got to do.
Good drop kick by Horner, taking the big man off his feet. Horner back to that wrist lock, tagging in Allen Iron Eagle, the young 19-year-old sensation coming right off the second turnbuckle.
He and Iron Eagle, they got to use their assets to their fullest advantage, and it's their speed and their quickness. They got to stay out of the way of the Big Cat and the Motor City Madman.
They certainly got to watch their assets too, Bob, because these two guys are about 700 pounds combined weight.
That's right. They can make a greasy spot out of you out in the center of the ring. Motor City, just that big and strong.
Madman, those right hands, and sending Iron Eagle for the ride. He's nailed from behind by the Big Cat. That knee caught Allen Iron Eagle right in the small of the back. Iron Eagle now at a big disadvantage, and you can see the Motor City Madman going right to work on the back of Allen Iron Eagle. Both these men use a version of a backbreaker. As a matter of fact, the Big Cat has tried to copy the human torture rack perfected by Lex Luger.
We have seen him use that hold time after time on the match. He's been very effective with it. I don't think he's of the caliber with it so far that Lex Luger is, but he's been awfully, awfully effective. Iron Eagle, Jim, while he's a big one, no match for them in size and power, and he doesn't have a great deal of experience either.
Trying to get him over. Horner helps out. Iron Eagle's got the pinning predicament here, and he got a two count out of it. Great teamwork by Horner and Iron Eagle, with the Big Cat right back on the advantage, working on the back of the young Indian from the state of Kansas. Tag made, they double team him. Tandem elbows there by Big Cat and the Motor City Madman, both men well over 300 pounds.
Jim, as you say, when they double team you, you're meeting about 700 pounds of rock in the ring. And that's what Iron Eagle ran into.
Side slam by the Motor City Madman, tagging in the Big Cat. We're going to hear some comments from Lex Luger in a few moments. There's Tim Horner in there. He's not going to stamp this double team. He nails the Motor City Madman. But in the meantime, the Big Cat has Allen Iron Eagle up in that human torture rack, a la Lex Luger. He's trying to copy Luger's hold. That's all. Iron Eagle gives it up. Get the official word here.
Right here, baby. That's right.
The winners of the match, the team of the Motor City Madman and the Big Cats.
All right, remember, they'll take on Lex Luger and El Gigante Christmas night in the Omni. We'll hear from Luger momentarily.
All right, and here you see that side slam. Again, showing you the tremendous power of the Motor City Madman on Allen Iron Eagle. And once they get you hurt, once they get you injured, they're going to stay right on top of you and stay after you. While Tim Horner occupied outside of the ring, the human torture rack did in Allen Iron Eagle.
The master of the human torture rack will be with El Gigante Christmas night in the Omni. Let's hear this from Lex Luger.
It's that time of year again. I'd like to wish everybody out there, all the WCW fans, a very happy holidays. It's a time for friends. It's a time for family. It's a very special time for all you little kids. It's much better to give than it is to receive. I hope you all receive a ton of good stuff out there. And then on Christmas night for me, I get to cap it off because it's me and Elegante, the biggest wrestler in the world, against Big Cat and Motor City Madmen. They get what's coming to them Christmas night right there in the Omni.
And welcome back, everyone, to World Championship Wrestling and TBS. You know, Bob, at Starrcade, and the World's Tag Team Championship matchup between Doom and the Horsemen with street fight rules. We thought two things would be settled there.
Jim, we certainly did. One of them, that it would certainly be a physical match, and it was that. One of the most physical matches we'd ever seen. The amount of punishment they both took was just tremendous. Also, we thought it would settle the feud between these two. It did not, as you're aware, and as we'll show the fans.
Fans, let's go back to Starrcade and join the street fight for the World Tag Title in progress.
All four men now starting it off here. Nick Patrick has the unenviable task of being the referee in this contest. All four men have their fists heavily taped. Simmons slamming Windham out on the way down the aisle on the rampway.
Well, this is really going to be explosive. I mean, Double A Arn Anderson and Barry Windham, their leader, the only member of the Horsemen to have been a member of the Horsemen since day one. Ric Flair, out of action, finished, perhaps forever, hurt in the limo attack. And this is really going to be a war.
Simmons and Anderson down the aisle with fist and fire. Windham trying to suplex Reed, who reverses Windham, has he won, and suplexes him. A tremendous vertical suplex on top for the cover. I don't think this match will have a long duration of time.
And I think Simmons is in a lot of trouble.
Anderson up there on the second turnbuckle.
Oh!
He was met by the clothesline. Reed knocked Windham out of the way. And Simmons met him with a clothesline. Windham for the ride. Inside cradle. Windham's got him. They're both men at pin. The referees count four teams. Both men were pinned.
Well, who won?
The referee is. Look at the referee. Nick Patrick. He counted both teams down.
So who wins?
We got a double pin. What do we have? Windham over the top. The bell sounded, but they're still fighting.
So who won the match?
Hey, what's going on?
Well, both men were counted down. They're fighting back down the rampway.
Hey, where the bell?
We'll have to get a clarification on the ruling. We don't have it yet. Anderson elevated on the runway.
Windham
clotheslines it.
I want you at WrestleWar 91.
World Championship Wrestling presents an ironclad event of man versus metal. WrestleWar 91, featuring War Games.
We've declared war.
Witness a grueling double steel cage confrontation where anything can happen. Don't miss the Duel in the Desert live from Phoenix, Arizona. You can be there front and center only on pay-per-view.
Dismissed! Ladies and gentlemen, making his way in the ring area from Memphis, Tennessee, is 220 pounds, Ricky Martin! And his opponent already in the ring at 235 pounds, one half of the team of the State Patrol, Lieutenant James Earl Wright.
Lieutenant James Earl Wright. I guess he's the late Broderick Crawford's favorite wrestler. And somebody's probably saying, now what the heck does that mean?
Well,
nobody remembers
Bill. I do. I remember Broderick Crawford. Highway Patrol was the name of the program, Jim. It was a winner on television for many years.
I'm dating myself, Bob.
Yeah,
but I was a little bitty guy when that
yeah,
was
Yeah, I know. We both were, huh? Very young.
Uh-oh, he said, watch the hair. That's got to be the biggest fallacy of the night so far is watch the hair. You can get a microscope and tweezers and find enough hair to pull.
He's been looking for that hair for a long time himself, and he hasn't been able to find it up there. That's just how slick that is. Fans, let me remind you, Thursday night, 7:30, Knoxville, Tennessee, World Championship Wrestling at the Civic Coliseum. and in Charleston, South Carolina at McAllister Fieldhouse. And then Friday night at 8 o'clock, Jacksonville, Florida at Memorial Coliseum. Just two more outstanding nights of World Championship Wrestling this coming week.
I also want to say hello to the fans in Greenville, South Carolina. World Championship Wrestling in Greenville, Christmas afternoon at 2 o'clock. We want to leave those great fans out. An outstanding holiday event, Christmas afternoon at 2 o'clock in Greenville. Promoter Chip Burnham's got a great holiday spectacular for you fans up there. Nice hip-lock takeover by Ricky Morton into the arm drag. And Ricky Morton now working on the wrist of Lieutenant James Earl Wright. Bob, it was great to see Robert Gibson last Sunday in St. Louis at Starrcade. Robert's doing a lot better. He's still got a long journey to go before he's going to be back in the ring, but it was great to see Robert Gibson and at ringside.
Yeah, you're right, Jim, but he's got a heart as big as all outdoors, and as you say, he's got a long way to come, but if anybody can do it, Robert Gibson is the type of individual that can.
Good Japanese arm drag by Ricky Morton taking Lieutenant James Earl Wright down. More traditional version of that same maneuver back into the wrist lock. Fans still to come now in our second hour here tonight. The Z-Man and Dutch Mantell. You'll see the Master Blasters, plus the Junkyard Dog, a special World Heavyweight Championship report with our colleague Gordon Solie, plus Tommy Rich and Michael Wall Street.
I got to get it right. Yes, sir.
And the match where the computer says Wall Street will win in 6 minutes or less, plus Rick Steiner and Michael Hayes in the captain's match with a U.S. tag title match at stake in that one.
Well, I tell you, there's still a lot to come, Jim. This is a fantastic 2 hours of wrestling right here. And I'm anxious to see. I know that computer has not been wrong, but when you say that Tommy Rich is going to be taken out in 6 minutes or less by Michael Wall Street, that brother, I got to see.
We'll find out the validity of their computer program. We'll find out just how smart Ms. Alexandra York, the administrative assistant of Michael Wall Street, really is, because that's a tall order to beat Tommy Rich in 6 or less.
It is, yeah, but I tell you, she's been making a believer out of me in recent weeks with that computer, Jim. She's been right on the money so far.
Christmas night in the Omni. Horseman versus Doom. They hope to settle their situation once and for all. Big right hand there by Lieutenant James Earl Wright, but Ricky Morton fights back with rights of his own.
Morton and Gibson, so long as teammates for a long, long time as the Rock and Roll Express.
Oh, all the way to post.
Wow. They've had tremendous success, and Morton is more or less had to go it alone in recent months, Jim.
Well, you know, Bobby's had Tommy Rich as his partner, and I think they've done quite well. They did great at Starrcade, but it's not the same without Robert Gibson.
No, that's right. Well, he's in pain now, and he's hurting. He hit that post, and he hit it hard right on that shoulder.
Let's see if Lieutenant James Earl Wright takes advantage of this situation Ricky Morton finds himself in. Lieutenant James Earl Wright is a veteran competitor, and he is very, very tough. And what an upset it would be if he would defeat Ricky Morton right here on World Championship Wrestling.
Well, it would be that, but Morton now fighting more or less with just one wing, that right hand, that left hand, just about out of commission as he's really taking it on his shoulder, and Wright has stayed right with that shoulder. It's smart on his part, and again, he's just driving the rights hard to the shoulder.
Fans, don't forget tomorrow night here on TBS, 6:05 Eastern Time, two big rematches from Starrcade. The Z-Man versus beautiful Bobby Eaton, and Terry Taylor meets Michael Wall Street. Plus, Big Van Vader will be with us right here exclusively on TBS tomorrow night, 6:05 Eastern Time. We hope you'll be with us. There'll be no danger zone, Bob, though, tomorrow night. I hope that doesn't affect your viewing, even though Paul Lee's not going to be in the danger zone. He's not too happy about that.
No, he may not be too happy about it. It really doesn't upset me, Jim. And it won't. I'll be right there watching, that's for sure.
Running knee lift there by Ricky Morton. Lieutenant James Earl right now in a degree of trouble. Ricky Morton's shoulder, he's still bothering him. You can tell that. Morton up and over. Sunset flip. He's got the waist lock. He's got the legs in place. And a victory for Ricky Morton.
The winner of the event, Ricky Morton.
Ricky Morton overcame a lot of adversity here. He really rammed his shoulder into the steel ring post, Bob. But he fought back for a victory.
And, Jim, we're going to get a good look at that as Morton now is going to go right after Lieutenant James Earl Wright. And look at this as he missed in the corner. Wham! And he hit it with a full head of steam, driving that shoulder hard into that and into that ring post. A gallant comeback by Ricky Morton fighting with more or less one arm. Watch this beautiful move out of the corner for the sunset flip in the wind for Ricky Morton.
Fans, when we come back, it's the Z-Man and Dirty Dutch Mantel. Our second hour still to come on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way into the ring area at 251 pounds, he hails from Minneapolis, Minnesota, it's Z-Man! And his opponent already in the ring, from Oil Trough, Texas, at 230 pounds, Dirty Dutch Mantel.
The Dirty Dutchman. A tough, tough man from Oil Trough, Texas, to take on the handsome youngster from Minneapolis, Minnesota. A man that we mentioned earlier has got to be on one of the hottest winning streaks in world championship wrestling today. And next week on this broadcast, live from the center stage in Atlanta, right here on West Peachtree, he's going to be taking on Arn Anderson for the television championship of the world.
Well, you're right. And Jim, also tomorrow on the main event right here on TBS at 6:05, it's going to be the Z-Man against Bobby Eaton, and that'll be a whale of a match. But I tell you, he's got his work cut out for him in this one. Dirty Dutch Mantel, he's going to take him to the limits, and Z-Man is not only going to have to wrestle a good match, he's going to have to wrestle a very smart match to prevail over Dutch Mantel.
Z-Man holds on to the side headlock very tenaciously. And he got a great ovation when he came out here. Fans really love this youngster.
Especially all the young women, Jim.
Yeah, I kind of noticed that.
Yeah, Bob. I think it kind of hurts you and I a little bit that he should get such an ovation for the young women.
I'm used to it by now, Bob. It's really, I'm thick-skinned, as that as the old expression would go. Back up to the vertical base side headlock there by the Z-Man. Has it locked in on Dirty Dutch Mantel.
Well, as you said, here this youngster's really been on a roll recently, Jim. He feels it, he's feeling it now, and he has wrestled really outstanding matches against competitors in recent months, and the cream really beginning to rise to the top. The experience, you can see him in every match, he gets better and better.
Z-Man with the elbow, nice move there, counter move on Mantel. Mantel, the veteran from Oil Trough, Texas, throws Z-Man on his shoulders. He may have a handful of tights there, couldn't tell from our vantage point, but he sure snapped him over there very easily.
Well, you better believe Mantel, he's going to use all the tricks he knows, and he's got a bag full of them.
Mantel backs Z-Man now in the corner. I said Mantel can come out with the advantage.
He's not known as Dirty Dutch because he doesn't take a bath, Jim.
Yeah, he's a break the rules. Good drop kick. Nailing Dirty Dutch Mantel. And Mantel rolls outside. Mantel not too pleased with the way things are progressing here thus far.
Well, I think Mantel thought that he was going to get into the ring and he was going to maul the young guy. He was just going to take him right out of his game plan, so to speak. And he was going to have things more or less his own way. I really think he's surprised by Z-Man. Although, knowing what Z-Man has done in recent months, he shouldn't have been.
By the looks of his back, it looks like he's already got one of his Christmas presents, a nice mohair sweater. Keeps it very trim, though. You got to give him
that.
Yeah,
it is trim. That's right.
I wish he'd do the same for his hair and his beard. Mantel shot off by Z-Man, who catches him coming off of the scoop slam. Great counter move. Step again deep. Another nice drop kick by the Z-Man. Arm drag, takeover. Dirty Dutch Mantel now with a disadvantage as the Z-Man bars that arm.
Well, when the Z-Man turns it up a notch, Mantel's no match for that speed and quickness.
Mantel rakes the eyes after the two count. And now Dirty Dutch Mantel has a little bit of an advantage here. Ramming the youngster, as we said, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, right into the top turnbuckle.
Oh, he hit him a good lick, too. He's really staggering around. Now he's gone to the
edge. Oh, that's blatant infraction of the rules. Dirty Dutch Mantel raking in the eyes of the Z-Man, and now the rule breaker from Oil Trough, Texas, has the advantage in this short clothesline. One of his favorite offensive weapons. There's a lateral press, and a referee, Randy Anderson, got two out of it.
You know, we got some great World Championship Wrestling fans all around the Baltimore area, Jim. Next Saturday, the 29th at 1 p.m., Baltimore Arena. World Championship Wrestling will be there. And that night at 8 p.m. in Philadelphia at the Civic Center. That's two great towns. Two great towns for World Championship Wrestling. I always love to go to Baltimore and Philadelphia.
I want to say hello to my good
pal and native Oklahoma, Coach Buddy Ryan, and the Philadelphia Eagles. The Eagles having a great season. We'll be in Philadelphia 1 week from tonight at 8 o'clock at the Civic Center.
And then the very next day, next Sunday, that's the 30th, in Chicago, another great town, Jim, at the UIC Pavilion.
Mantell,
great fans there.
He's using the ropes for leverage. Mantell, notorious for taking shortcuts. Reverse chin lock applied. And referee Randy Anderson questioning Mantell's integrity, which I'm sure has been questioned on many occasions before.
Well, he might question his veracity, too, when he asks him a question like that.
Quite a word for a conservative Republican like you,
Bob.
Yeah. Not bad. Z-Man trying to work his way back up and relieve some of the pressure. He's back up to the vertical base now and goes downstairs with the elbow. Z-Man the ropes for a little momentum, but Mantell missed the clothesline. But Z-Man did not miss his. Mantell quickly moved out of the way. He avoided the drop kick there. You got to hand it to Dirty Dutch Mantell on that move. He was one step ahead of the Z-Man on that occasion. But the Z-Man fights back.
Yeah, he certainly was that. You're getting mad, though, I tell you, Jim. He comes out. He gets irate. He really turns it on. Oh, and out of the ring. Boy, he really hit a pop. But, you know, here's the youngster in against the man like Dutch Mantell. Then tomorrow night on the main again against Bobby Eaton. And next week for the World Television Championship. All of them right here on TBS.
You got to admire his confidence and his own ability. He said a little bit early there, and Mantell caught him. And Mantell went for a drop kick. Very uncharacteristic of the Dirty Dutchman to go to the air, but this is not unusual. The Z-Man with a drop kick right off the top rope. And he has won it here.
Winner of the event, Z-Man!
Fans, this is our Nintendo Instant Replay. Of course, Nintendo, the makers of Tetris. Now you're playing with power. And the Z-Man has got that power, Bob.
Well, he certainly has, Jim. And there you see him coming off of the rope with that clothesline, flooring the Dirty Dutchman, Dutch Mantell. And then that flying drop kick off of the top rope for the count out. 1, 2, 3.
Fans, Paul E. Dangerously is standing by with the Z-Man. Let's go to Paul E.
45 straight wins. 45 straight victories, and next week you have the opportunity of a lifetime. You will fight Double A Arn Anderson for the World Television title. Do you really think? I know you're on a big roll, Z-Man. I know you've been mowing down all the competition. Do you really think you can upset the Enforcer for the World TV title?
Yes, I do. I think I can do it.
You really think, I mean, you're walking into the ring with a man, the best wrestler on television today.
I agree with you. He's great. He's a great. He's probably the best TV champion ever. Okay? You're right. I'll give you that much.
Well, then I tell you what. I'll give... Well. Now, hold it.
Is this your idea?
No, this is
you
not...
You set this up.
Wait a minute. Hold on. No fights out here. You yourself... You have to defend your title next week. You yourself have been injured. You have stitches. You have broken knuckles. You're already walking into a match at a disadvantage. Don't take an opportunity here.
Don't tell me what I can or can't do. People been telling me what I couldn't do all my life. A lot of people call me an overachiever, Zink. They say, you're not big enough. You don't have a body like Tom Zink. You shouldn't have got what you got in this life. Well, my friend, you look in these eyes, and I look in yours, and I see that same fire, and I still see that same hunger, that will to achieve when everybody thinks you can't. But remember one thing, Greek gods. This may be a grandstand play for you, a way to get a beautiful woman, but by God, that's how I make my living, and I'm better than everybody else. A couple of broke knuckles, a few stitches, makes no difference. When you're a world-class athlete, when you're a world champion, you suck it up and go. Now, you want to be somebody, you want to elevate yourself, next week, my friend, make your grandstand play right on this show. I don't think you're man enough to jump on me. Bottom line.
I'll be here, Arn Anderson. Just come alone, huh?
in this event, making their way into the ring area from Detroit, Michigan, with a combined weight of 582 pounds, the Master Blaster. And introducing their opponents already in the ring with a combined weight of 495 pounds, Joe Barrett and Brett Wayne.
All right, fans, Brett Wayne, the black tights, Joe Barrett in the fluorescent pink, if you will, to take on the big Master Blasters. Still to come in our second hour, the Junkyard Dog, plus the special championship report with Gordon Solick, Tommy Rich and Michael Wall Street, one-on-one, Rick Steiner and Michael Hayes, one-on-one. So a lot more action to come right here on TBS as Brett Wayne overhand wristlock with Blade of the Master Blasters. And you see great power, Bob, in this team.
Oh, Jim, they are tremendous. They are huge, big, strong, rough, tough individuals, like so many of them now that are just about threatening to take over and rule professional wrestling. If it wasn't for guys like the Steiners, if it wasn't for guys like Lex Luger, there's just no telling what guys like this could do.
Of course, the Master Blasters have been lobbying in their own crude way for a match with the Steiners for the United States Tag Team Championship. Seems to be a very popular title right now for people to be going after. I don't understand the exact logic behind it, because the Steiners are as good as there ever has been in tag team wrestling.
Well, there's got to be a lot of egos involved in that too, Jim, and I'm sure a team like the Master Blasters, as big and as strong as they are, they say, hey, we can take the Steiners. We can take them any day of the week.
Brett Wayne trying to drop kick, didn't even take Blade off his feet, and there's Steele, who missed the elbow. Now, he's 6'10", over 300 pounds. Joe Barrett comes down. That didn't even phase this big giant.
That's just how big and how strong he is. He can withstand a lot of punishment. He can keep coming right at you. It takes a lot to make him back up or even to stop him in his tracks.
Barrett trying to counter right
there. No way. He's got him blocked. He can't do it.
Master Blaster Steele with that clothesline. 6'10", probably about 325 pounds. And he is all man, Bob.
Well, there's not an ounce of fat on this young man. There's no doubt about that. It's all muscle. Master Blasters, he's all steel.
Barrett sent for the ride. Double team move by the Master Blasters. Steele follows it up with a clothesline. Joe Barrett in a lot of trouble here. Blade drops a knee right on Joe Barrett. A little choking there as the referee caught it.
I think he went down for the choke. That's right, Jim. There's no way. How are you going to come back when you take a pounding like this? You got to get to your corner, and you got to make a tag.
And Arn Anderson has some pointed remarks to make to Z-Man a little bit earlier in the broadcast here in our second hour about the big championship match in 7 days right here on World Championship Wrestling. Double clothesline by the Master Blasters. And Joe Barrett now desperately needs to make a tag, because these big guys now have taken over solidly on their opponents, and he takes him straight down. Referee counting, that was a chokehold.
Well, he grabbed him right around the throat, coming off of the ropes, just sort of lifted him off of the mat and drove him to the mat with that one big hand. Excess power.
Barrett trying to go for the sunset flip. Here comes Brett Wayne in there, and Blade blocked the sunset flip.
Too much power.
Boom! Double shoulders by the Master Blasters. And they're ready for the Steiners or anyone else.
The winners of the match, the team of the Master Blasters.
They're a little rough around the edges. They're a big power team. But that would be an interesting matchup with them and the Steiners. There's a clothesline big time.
Well, as you say, they may be rough around the edges, but they've got the size and the power and the force to overcome that, Jim. The double block coming off. Good timing, good power.
Making his way into the ring area from Charlotte, North Carolina, at 310 pounds, J.Y.D., the Junkyard Dog. And his opponent from Knoxville, Tennessee, 225 pounds, this is Joe Cazzana.
Fans will have a little report on Norman here momentarily, but right now, let's hear these comments made earlier today from the Junkyard Dog. Remember, he's going to be in the Omni Christmas night.
You know, Christmas is my favorite time of the year. When I get together with my family, we all go out and have a good time. But right here in the Omni, Christmas night, you'll see the Junkyard Dog live in a sure enough living color doing this thing. And I'm going to ring the bell once for you.
You know, Bob, a lot of fans won't realize this, but the Junkyard Dog and his family will be passing out food to the needy all day Christmas Day, thanks to the great people at the Farmers Market in Atlanta, just north of Atlanta. Certainly appreciate their benevolence, their hearts, and so the Junkyard Dog in the right place in this wonderful time of the year. JYD, not so wonderful for Joe Barrett right now.
Jim, we talk about hard heads, and I mean that literally. This guy's got one of the hardest heads you'll ever find on anybody, and with that headbutt, he certainly uses it to his great advantage, because Anana getting back through the ropes after being thrown right out of the ring. And that brings to mind about Norman and what kind of shape you think Norman's head might be in at the moment.
Well, we just got a report from the locker room area that Norman's experiencing a lot of dizziness. He may have a minor concussion because he really cracked that ring post thanks to Sid Vicious, and Norman having trouble keeping his equilibrium. So we'll hopefully have another report on Norman before we go off the air. JYD returning the favor in kind there to Joe Kazana. And now we just may see how hard. There's that headbutt. He says,
hold it
right. Oh, down he goes. Junkyard Dog wrestles at his own methodical pace. Clothesline by the 300-plus pounder.
Fans, you know, in all sports, there's one event, I think, that stands out head and shoulders above them all. And in this sport of professional wrestling, Jim, it happens to be the Christmas Night Spectacular each year at the Omni in Atlanta. This Christmas night, what a great, great gala it's going to be, with 9 terrific matches, including the world title match and the cage match with a Horseman against Doom. That's just 2 of the tremendous matches Christmas night in the Omni.
We'll be telling our fans in Atlanta more about the big Christmas night event. Just a few more moments. JYD with the working on the neck, working on the head of Joe Kazana. JYD sends him for the ride. Downstairs, buries that big right hand side Russian leg sweep by the Junkyard Dog. And JYD will be passing out food to the needy in Atlanta on Christmas Day.
The winner of the match, Junkyard Dog!
I think more and more athletes should be and have their heart in the same spot that JYD does. I don't mean in their body physically. I mean in their feelings.
That's right, and in his feelings toward his fellow man and the fact that he always wants to assist the needy. Here's the move that put Joe Kazana down for the count of 1-2-3 with the winner, Junkyard Dog.
Fans, a lot of controversy surrounded the World's Heavyweight Championship match this past Sunday night at Starrcade. When we come back, Gordon Solie will have a special World Championship report on TBS.
This is a world championship report concerning the most recent world championship match between Sting and the Black Scorpion. May I just say it was a monumental occasion, full of confusion, as there turned out to be 5 scorpions in all, a locked steel cage, the arrival of the Horsemen, and much, much more. Rather than talk about it, let's go back to Starrcade 90 in St. Louis at Kiel Auditorium and take a look at what happened in this steel cage match between Sting and the Scorpion.
I think I'm wearing Gordon Solie's bifocals. I'm seeing double.
Well, we've got more blacks. Wait a minute here. We got one in the ring. There's another one.
What?
There's 4 of them.
What was in that grapefruit juice you gave me earlier?
Vitamin C. So this is a little bit strange. 4 scorpions.
4 men you see are only messengers. There is only one true Black Scorpion, and it is I.
They are only messengers. There is only one Black Scorpion, and he said, it is I. And there is the man that we have waited to finally see in the ring with the heavyweight champion of the world.
I don't recognize him.
Well, if it's a Horseman in there,
then it leads for me to believe that it would be. There'll
no.
be another horseman under that mask.
Obviously. No, no way.
Scorpion is Ric Flair.
It's Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Sting won the title. He's retained the title. The Blessed Scorpion had to. It's Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Well, you saw as well as I did the bizarre turn of events that occurred during that World Heavyweight Championship match. But may I make another point? Not only did this world title match leave Sting a battered man physically, but he's battered emotionally. There's no question about that. We're going to be hearing from the World Heavyweight Champion Sting describing how he feels. And then we'll hear a retort from the former World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair. Let's go to those tapes.
Well, Flair, you did accomplish one thing. You made me feel real sick inside. I don't feel like howling. I don't feel like beating on my chest. The adrenaline isn't flowing like it normally does. You accomplished that, all right. But you didn't beat me. And the other thing you didn't accomplish is you didn't make yourself into a man at Starrcade. You kept yourself the same old way. Slime, pal!
Sting! That's the voice you've had to live with. That's the voice you've had to hear as you closed your eyes every night for 5 months. Sting. Well, now, Sting, now you hear the voice of Ric Flair. The voice that is really gonna haunt you until I wear that world title around my waist for the seventh time. It's the look of the 90s. Bigger, better, most of all, more determined than ever before to be the new world champion. Sting. Think about it. Ric Flair comes for the seventh time. Woo!
Making his way into the ring from Atlanta, Georgia, 218 pounds. This is Wildfire Tommy Ricks.
Well, let's find out just how valid Miss York's computer program is.
And introducing his opponent from the Financial District of Lower Manhattan in New York City, accompanied to the ring by his administrative assistant, Alexander York, at 243 pounds, Michael Wall Street.
Is he wrestling's version of J.R. Ewing? That music is almost indicative of that. Well, we heard the comments early in the program that she's got the computer program there. But early in our broadcast, according to their information, he will beat Tommy Wildfire Rich in 6 minutes or less. Now, when the bell sounds, we'll have our clock on that one, where yep. you'll be able to follow it, fans at home, and we'll see just exactly if Ms. York's research and her computer data is valid.
Well, we're going to see how accurate she is, and this is something we've been wanting to do, Jim, in recent weeks, is to check it out and just see. They've said, hey, you can do it in such and such minutes. We've always taken that for granted. We're going to find out. As you say, we're going to put the clock on it this week. That's a big order, Jim.
Collar and elbow tie-up. Nice arm drag takeover. Tommy Rich with the early advantage here. Miss Alexander York constantly inputting into her laptop computer some type of data as she stays at ringside during these contests. Good reversal by Tommy Wildfire Rich. And one thing about Tommy Rich, he's always been, I think, as tenacious as anybody in the sport. And it's almost insulting for Rich to hear that he's going to lose in 6 minutes or less.
Yeah, I mean, here's a man that has been in against the greats in this sport, Jim, Wildfire Tommy Rich, and for Michael Wall Street to say, I'm going to take you out, guy, and I'm going to do it in 6 minutes or less, as you say, I think is a tremendous
high cross body. He may have him here. 1, 2 and a half, and boy, Rotunda, or excuse me, Michael Wall Street comes up with a very concerned, perhaps bewildered look on his face.
Well, there's no doubt that money has changed this man, Michael Wall Street. Greed, I guess, they say it can do tremendous things to you, and it certainly has changed this man.
Wall Street catches Tommy Rich with a knee in the abdomen area. Tommy Rich, big favorite here at center stage. He's from right here in Atlanta. Elbow as Rich came off the ropes. Wall Street caught him with that elbow. Drops the elbow on him, and now Wall Street's opening up the offense. A succession of elbow drops. The leg is grapevine on top, but Rich got the shoulder up.
Had him for the count of two, Jim. Almost a pin. Wall Street is determined with his money and his ability, and hey, let's don't overlook that. Here's a guy that's got a bundle of ability, a sack full of it, as Michael Wall Street, but he's determined he's going to rule his profession.
He's involved in that big rematch with Terry Taylor tomorrow, the main event. And he went to the corner for a shoulder block, and the former outstanding athlete from Syracuse is now being hammered by Tommy Rich, who Irish strips Wall Street, catches him coming off, and now Rich is dominant on top, lateral press, and Wall Street kicked out.
Neckbreaker.
Good move by Tommy Rich. On top again. And you can hear the one, the two, and Wall Street up quickly with a right hand. Inside cradle. Wall Street had that right shoulder up. Tommy couldn't quite get the hole cinched in, Bob.
Well, I tell you, you can see outside of the ring, Alexandra York, I don't know how much confidence she's got in that computer of hers, Jim, but she's pacing very nervously outside, and well, she should be.
You know, we're about halfway through this situation, and he's not looking too good as far as his prediction is concerned.
No, if anything, Jim, I would think that right now that it's Wildfire Tommy Rich carrying the action. He's taking it to Michael Wall Street.
On top, again, another near fall as Tommy Rich, I think, is taking this very personally.
We may have to throw that computer right out the window after this match.
Tommy Rich now, again, going for the cover. Man, he's wrestling a real offensive match here against Michael Wall Street. Catches him with the elbow.
I think that's very smart on Rich's part, too, Jim, is to come out and really come at him and fight him. Stand toe-to-toe. Don't back up. And don't be timid at all.
What a
tackle. He certainly hasn't been.
Rotunda rakes the eyes. They really collided there on that tackle.
Lost him.
Rich is back up on the apron. And Wall Street drops. He's got the ropes. He's got the ropes, and he pinned him. Rich had it going his way. Wall Street used the ropes to pin him, and he pinned him in under 6 minutes,
the
as you can see.
Michael Wall Street.
A look of arrogance.
Oh, my heavens. I don't know, Jim, the validity of the computer or whether you got to say it was the ropes in this instance or not, but at least the prediction certainly held true. There's that tremendous collision, and underneath the rope went Wildfire Tommy Rich. Wall Street got up, looked stunned for a moment, looked like he had lost Rich. He couldn't find him. Then watch this move.
Tommy Rich attempted the sunset flip there. Wall Street, now watch, his hands are not on the rope. The referee gets out
there
of position. He holds the rope. He wins it in under 6 minutes. I guess you gotta say the computer is still right. Rick Steiner, Michael Hayes, they're next on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a one-fall television time remaining. This is a captain's match. Introducing first, from Bad Street, USA, in Atlanta, Georgia, at 230 pounds, Michael T.S. Hayes.
Of all the great events in the Omni on Christmas night, many of them the fans can look back on and say the Free Birds were involved. They'll be involved. They'll be in the Omni, Bob, Christmas night, right here in Atlanta. But this is a high-stakes match, a deal made earlier today by Michael Hayes and Jimmy Jam Garvin.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing from the University of Michigan at 260 pounds, this is Rick
Ladies and gentlemen, if you just joined us, that man, Rick Steiner, defeated Barry Horowitz earlier in the broadcast.
Then Rick was being interviewed by Paul E. Dangerously, and the Freebirds came out and offered a deal. If Michael Hayes wins the match right here, then the Freebirds will get a United States tag team match with those two, the Steiner brothers. If Rick Steiner wins, then the Freebirds will remove themselves from any type of competition for the U.S. Tag Team Championship.
And you know, knowing the Freebirds, Jim, as I know the Freebirds, and as I know Michael P.S. Hayes, Jimmy Garvin, I gotta be leery of this. I just gotta believe that somewhere Michael P.S. Hayes, he's got a backup plan somewhere.
Hayes pushing Rick Steiner back into the ropes. Clean break by Michael Hayes. Well, he said it was, you know, in the spirit of the moment, the Freebirds came out and extended their hand in sportsmanship. That's about as apt to happen as Saddam Hussein having a Christmas brunch with President Bush in the White House.
Yeah, and as you say, it may be the Christmas season, but he didn't do that out of the goodness of his heart, that you're certain.
You know, Bob, we get caught up in wrestling, and that's exactly why we're here, to bring the very best wrestling to the fans. But two things we want to say here. Number one, we hope everybody has a great Christmas, and we especially want to wish a Merry Christmas to the families of the fighting men and women in Operation Desert Shield.
Jim, you're 100% right.
A little bite there.
Yes, sir.
A bite out of crime or somewhere.
America's finest over there in Saudi Arabia in the desert, Jim, and we hope all of them have a tremendous Christmas, and as you say, all of their families. And talking about Christmas, I've been sitting here thinking a terrific stocking stuffer would be tickets to the Omni, Jim, on Christmas night, and tickets are still available. Fans, quickly, you can get them at Ticketmaster outlets, including Turtles, Coconuts, Selected Eckerd's, also available at the Omni box office on Christmas Day, and that will be until match time. But you know, it'd be great to get up on Christmas morning, have that stuffed in the stocking somewhere.
Dog face down on all fours, and Michael Hayes trying to quiet the crowd here from getting they call it the 12th man at Texas A&M. Oh, right there.
That's old Mo, huh?
Old
Mo. Talking about Mo.
Michael Hayes checking the for teeth marks. I'll take his word for it.
I wouldn't put it past Steiner. Jim, you never know what he's going to do. But you know what? I think regardless, I think he always has fun doing it.
Fans, we understand Norman is being assisted from the building. He's still experiencing some dizziness and some headaches, rightfully so, after being rammed headfirst into the ring post by Sid Vicious. We'll have an update on that hopefully tomorrow on the main event at 6:05. Wrist lock there by Rick Steiner. Michael Hayes has tried a lot of offense, Bob, thus far, but the good-natured Rick Steiner's pretty well controlled things, and I think he just pulled the hair.
He did.
He said, yeah, I did it.
Yeah, grabbed him by the hair and slung him to the mat.
Now, how many times do you see someone admit that they pull the hair? Naivety or honesty, one or the other, but he admitted it.
Yeah, I think he wanted to do that, Jimmy. Let him up. I think probably he wants to pull it and throw him down again.
I'm surprised he didn't tell referee Mike Atkins, I'm sorry. Another side headlock by one half of the United States Tag Team Champions. Boy, they made America proud at Starrcade. Pat O'Connor International Tag Team Tournament. Quick movement here in this contest. And he caught him! Hayes tried to leapfrog, and the Dogface caught him in midair and power slammed him.
And boy, Hayes felt that one, every bone in his body. The tremendous power that Rick Steiner had behind that. Boy, it shook him right down to his toenail.
We missed the earthquake a few weeks ago, but I think that the streets were quaking on Bad Street.
Hey, here's Garvin.
And you slam him like real hard, and you pick him up and just slam him, and you punch him in the nose, and then you punch him in the stomach.
All right.
All kinds of stuff like
all
that.
Right.
Do all that stuff.
What?
You haven't.
Hey, Garvin's telling him exactly what to do.
Pretty good strategy if he can do it.
Yeah, if he could just do it. All he's got to do now is carry it out.
Jimmy Garvin out there eating an apple. Yeah, the big wink there. Something's up. Slam there by Hayes. He really planted him there, Bob. Scoops him up. Slams him again. Hayes thinks he's got him now. Rick Steiner right back up, though.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Rick Steiner now slamming Hayes. There's one. There's two.
Make it a trifecta. Straight right hand by Rick Steiner. And a four slam. Four powerful scoop slams on Michael Hayes. And you can see it's taking the fight right out of Hayes.
Well, it took it out of Hayes, but the slam didn't seem to have much effect on Rick Steiner. Now Hayes may be in bad trouble.
Hayes got him.
What a,
he snuck
what
that
a
left in. He snuck it in on him. And it found its mark. I don't know how much Hayes has got left in reserve after those four slams. There's a bulldog taking Rick Steiner down to the canvas, but Hayes is feeling the punishment in his lower back from those four body slams executed by Rick Steiner. DDT!
Wow.
He nailed him with a DDT! Hayes in no position to make the cover. Jimmy Garvin giving Hayes some coaching there.
Jim, I don't know that I've ever seen anybody get up from the DDT.
Uh-oh. Rick Steiner on the outside. Dangerous position here with the referee's back is turned, but Jimmy Jam Garvin is not taking advantage of it. What's going on here? Very uncharacteristic of the Freebirds.
Oh, well, Hayes, you're right.
Got,
but,
you got it.
But here comes Hayes right back out after him.
Hayes with those big right hands.
Garvin may be trying to disarm him or something here, Jim.
Well, maybe they are caught up in the Christmas spirit. Maybe it is a time for goodwill toward men. And
I can't believe that in the Freebirds. Garvin is not doing that because of that. I can't believe it's because of the goodness of their heart.
Hayes in the right hand. Rick Steiner fighting back and fighting back again. A championship match for the U.S. title hangs in the balance. And this one, Hayes is really elevated there. Steiner line. He really got racked. And another one. Rick Steiner now becoming very dominant in this contest. He's setting Hayes up for the coup de grace.
Hey, he's got the referee in.
He just tossed. He just, Jimmy Garvin
what
just tossed.
Throwing?
He just tossed a board, a 2x4, to Michael, to Rick Steiner. Hayes.
Oh, wait
up
a minute.
The referee has.
Oh, my God, he's going to get an Academy Award for this.
The referee is going to disqualify Rick Steiner. For the use of that board. He didn't even. Garvin threw the board in.
The winner of the match, Michael P.S. Hayes.
Are you kidding me?
Come on, no way.
The Freebirds get a United States Tag Team title match. This is the cheapest victory the Freebirds have ever stolen.
Look,
Hayes is acting like he got hit with a board.
Look at the acting job that Hayes is putting on.
Garvin threw Rick Steiner that 2x4. The referee did not see that.
Just
Hayes.
Plain reflexes, you're going to take it, Jim. That was all Steiner could do.
Look at Garvin making fun of Rick Steiner. Oh, he just nailed him with that board. Laugh that one off. The Freebirds will get their match for the United States Tag Team Championship. And let's go back and look. Here's where it all happened.
And fans, you can get a perfectly good look at it. As Garvin just throws the board over, Rick Steiner caught it out of the air. What else was he going to do? And here's the acting job that Michael Hayes put on. Into the corner with a referee who had his back turned to it. Hayes now is just going to fall to the mat, grab his head, and say, hey, you've been clobbered. Look at this. And Steiner wasn't within 5 feet of him.
Hayes needs an Oscar. Garvin needs first aid. But the Freebirds get their U.S. Tag Team Championship match.
A very tainted victory, Bob, for the Freebirds. They'll get the U.S. tag title matchup with the Steiners.
Jim, no doubt about that. And from the very beginning, you had to believe that the Freebirds, Michael P.S. Hayes, had some devious plan in mind and in store for the Steiners, and indeed it did for Rick Steiner.
Fans, don't forget, we certainly hope and want to thank everyone here at Center Stage for being here tonight. Christmas.
Excuse me. You saw it tonight. What a journalistic genius that I am, and you take it upon yourself. Tomorrow night, you say, no danger zone on the main event. Well, I'll tell you what, it's going to be a great show, and the reason everybody's going to be watching the main event tomorrow night is because I'm going to have a whole bunch of picketers with signs right outside the arena. We are going to picket the main event until the danger zone is back on the air. Thank you, Big Show.
Well, why don't you go call your mom and daddy? Maybe they care, because we don't and nobody here cares. Fans, don't forget, we'll see you tomorrow night at 6:05 on the main event.